The fees, well, right now this proposal is all on fees. If we raise the fees $5 for those particular programs, the playground, the enrichment programs, some of the sponsorships, if everybody came back last year, we would have over $7,000.
So then you wouldn't need any of those additional.
I wouldn't need any if everybody came back.
I'm fine with that then.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to,
right.
You know, I just have an issue with that because I understand the reason one is forever, but one of the things that we talked about even at budget time was fireworks, you know?
Right.
And I mean, I'm not saying it's going away, but it was brought up. So what if it does, you know? And then what?
Right.
So I just wanted to make sure that we were having those discussions.
Can't we just, like if grants or that type of funding goes away, just plan it as go away? I mean,
then what you have is, but you have someone still getting the retirement benefit even if we were to cut back on the hours. Do you know what I mean? So you still would have to fund that retirement cost at least.
I really feel that the benefits can be covered by the fees. And we're only upping some of these programs $5.
Yeah.
And it's just amazing what $5 does when you multiply it times all of these things that are happening.
So just to be clear, if we have the proposal, we increase cost about $47.74 without backfilling the 23 hours that Teresa's currently working. If you backfill that, then you're looking at about 9,100 hours to move her into this other position and fill the hours that she would be making.
But we wouldn't backfill that position, correct?
Well, I guess that's the question.
She did various things, and the ones that were done by the school, we didn't even pay those because she did summer school in the morning of June and July, so that didn't really affect us. But it would be also paid by a person with lower, like a lifeguard that makes $9. She subbed out there also. She subbed at day camp. She was in the office. In the summertime, we just need an extra hand, and that was her. And she was very good at it all. She's very versatile. So.
So you're not recommending that we fill that 23 hours where you are?
If you ask me not to, I will not fill that 23 hours. I will just have her, you know.
Because based on your letter that you sent out, my understanding was that you weren't going to fill that.
Okay.
But I guess I.
Until Phil really said it to me tonight, I wasn't thinking in those terms either that, no, that we she would take on something different here and we will use what we have where we have it.
Yeah, and I wasn't looking at it that way either until I was re-looking at this afternoon and I'm like, okay, 12 hours, that makes sense. But then what happens to the other 23?
Right.
So are we able to not have this instructor?
Right.
And that's where I was looking at. So, yeah, I didn't mean to bring it up to you on the tonight.
No, I know. I appreciate you bringing it up because no, we won't fill that in that capacity.
But I do think it would bring some continuity to the position. It would make it easier because this person already knows. I mean, it just makes planning much easier.
And I think there'd be a lot more efficient.
The supervision will be the key thing.
The key and efficiency to getting things done and having somebody there all the time. And having an adult there is just.
And that supervision may help out with some of the other things where, like I said, creating more efficiency, these other hours may not even be lost.
Right.
Those are the 20.
Right.
Asking for is a rounding error. I mean, it's really not a lot of money. And to me, the continuity and to get an employee that's going to stick around for a long time reduces a lot of headaches in terms of hiring, firing, having the right person, etc. So I think we should approve it.
Okay.
benefits, like you said, still add up to it. But
I feel better now that it's clear that your fees can completely cover the cost, because my only concern was using fundraising and grant dollars to cover an ongoing position.
Need a motion?
We do.
Make the motion to pass or to increase the hours for after school and recreation days.
I have a motion and a second to increase hours for after school and recreation aid for this summer. Is there any further discussion? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Number three, consideration of imposing a hiring freeze for full-time employee, full-time positions. This item will actually be moved to the mayor's quarterly meeting, which will be held 27th of this month. So we will discuss that as a full council at that meeting. D, any business by members? Yeah, we need a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
I have a motion and second to adjourn. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned.